Admiral Basil Hume spent more than an hour with refugees who found sanctuary in this rundown church hall. The decision of the Roman Catholic leader to intervene personally has put the fate of these Muslims firmly back in the headlines. 100 men sleep in the hall, twice that number are fed here. The toilets don't work properly and there's no hot water. Around 1,000 Kurds are now living like this in Hackney, Islington and Haringey, almost all cared for by churches of all denominations. So far, despite pleas for cash, there's been no government aid. At least 30 new refugees arrive in London every day. 50 turned up last night.
Well, I would like to see the government realising that these people are now in our midst and that as a nation we have a corporate responsibility to see what we can do. But somebody has to produce money. These people need to be fed, need to be cared for, and you can't do that for nothing. The churches have already provided money. I myself have brought down a little bit of money to help, but we need much more.
These Kurds are mainly from southeastern Turkey. They say they're fleeing persecution under a new political regime. Many claim to have been tortured.
He's saying that he has been beaten up, generally beaten up, then he was given electric shocks through his fingers and through his ears.
The Home Office say they're considering applications for political asylum, but in the meantime they're discussing detaining the refugees in prison.
Crazy is the only word I can think of, because after all, our prisons are already overcrowded. And I don't know, but as far as I know, 50 Kurds in prison for 1 week cost £12,000 a week.
The Home Office have repeated their claim that most of the Kurds are merely here seeking jobs. They say 80 have already gone back to Turkey of their own accord.